Hey lovebugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored and definitely hope the same for you. And if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome. And to my returning subs, my growing extended family, you know we are growing by the day, and it's just so, it feels so good to be able to have new people coming towards our community so we can share our love as well as experiences and information that can be able to help us all along the way. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light, and many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe, even hit that notification bell so you know when we're about to upload another video. If you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line or two. I love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me, even if it's about the positive feedback or the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your empathic gift, how it impacted your life and heading you towards a positive direction. And if you feel like the videos give you good vibes or even good information you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, or even a fellow empath that are going through trying times right now and need spiritual guidance or need confirmation or validation towards a life path or even soul purpose, please go ahead and share. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And thank you once again for the love and support. It's so greatly appreciated. And I hope you're able to resonate with the content of my video. And today, I've used this video meditation like about 3-4 months ago, but it really does like a strong, it has those very strong vibes to it, and it keeps giving me chills, and which is kind of, you know, kind of combines with the video I'm about to do. It's called Purify Your Soul, Pure Tone, Inner Peace Meditation, Spiritual Awakening, Healing Music, and I will post that link in the description box below. Twin Flame 101, Heyoka is when Goosebumps and chills confirm your alignment. It does. It's just like when you know you're heading towards something, and you know, especially with a lot of people that are going through spiritual awakenings right now, you get these vibes. Like I know there are certain things that I can talk about, and I'm like, I could be talking amongst myself, you know, and trying to get my thoughts together, trying to understand why certain things had to pop off the way they did. And it's just like a lot of times when we do that, we experience a lot of chills, and it's just like it's giving you that confirmation, hey, you're on the right path, or hey, you're talking to the right person, or hey, you know, these things are occurring for a certain reason. And you have to be able to break it down, like, why did this have to happen today? Or, you know, it's just like certain things have to come forth. Like you, when it, you could be praying or being confused, like you could be on a mission towards yourself to be bettering yourself, going towards your life, you know, your next life chapter, where you're bringing growth to your life, but you have people trying to intervene. You're like, some will allow you to just say something like, where the heck did that come from? Like, you'll say something, you're like, why did I say that? Or there'll be vibes just coming from the top of your root chakra down to your back, to your arms. Like, I was doing it right when I was, you know, getting ready to do this video. I was like, woo, yeah, you know, getting these chills. And I'm like, okay, y'all telling me. And it'll make you feel like you're being hugged by angels and stuff like that. You get this, like, chill that goes up and down your spine. And it's just like, I noticed a lot of people are really starting to experience those more, and it has a whole different vibe right now. You know, like you've been dealing with it before, but this vibe is coming off like, whoa, you know, that was very powerful. That had to come, you know, come towards you. So I feel a lot of folks are dealing with that right now, that it feels a lot different, you know, because I know I did a video, I did a video about chills or a ringing of the ear. It was something like that, but I don't know if I did the one about the goosebumps. But if I did, this is something totally different. So it's just like they want me to talk about, like, Roslynn, we need you to talk about these goosebumps. I'm like, hey, you know, you're the message. Hey, you tell me, I message. You know, just put all these messages out. But there's like so many things that are coming towards your life that, you know, angels wish they can just come down and just knock on your door and say, hey, you're going through this and this and this and that. But when you actually see how big these angels are, that can be kind of scary, you know. So you're trying to run away from, like, oh my god, you know, because it's just like I've had visions of angels, and they're very beautiful, but they're very freaking huge, you know. And I'm just like, oh my god, if I see something like this, I'm like, can I just die for a little bit? right now, because this is too big. I don't know why. It's just like, even if I've seen like the movie Godzilla, and you're sitting in a building, you see that big eye that takes up that whole window, and you already know there's something big behind this big eye. You know, I'm just like, you know what? I need to die right now, because I don't need to see this anymore. This is just too tragic for me, too traumatizing. But you know, just get off that. Just try to make a joke about it. But I'm just saying, you know, a lot of things are coming forth in our life, and they want you to be able to see your gift is in a blessing, not, you know, because a lot of us, I've even did it before when I first started doing this. I'm just like, why does being empath feel like such, you know, a curse as well as a blessing? Now it's just when I know I can be able to help people make sense of why they go through what they go through, you know, being able to confirm strange things that occur in their life. I feel like it's more than a blessing than a curse. You know, I try not to look at it that way, because it's like God made me this way for a reason. Even though there are certain times that it might bring on, you know, off the wall emotions for me when people tell me certain things and I can actually visualize what they've been through, is like that I don't like, you know. But being able to know I can bring the blessing towards people, because it seems like everybody I go on one-on-one with and we talk, It brings on unwanted emotions. I'm like, dang, I'm not trying to make nobody cry, but it just seems like anybody I've ever talked to on a one-on-one the first time, it brings up a lot of emotions. And it's just like, Roslynn, I've been, you know, you can see me. Other people can't see me the way you see me. I said it wasn't meant for other people too. That's the reason why you are the way you are. You have to be hidden in plain sight sometimes. It's just like, because if darkness and then, you know, you had to go through all these crazy things because you are that big gift, you know, towards the world. So a lot of times you have to be hidden in plain sight. A lot of times you have to be put in certain things that makes you totally opposite. Somebody might think that you're less than, you know, because you might be short or you have, you know, different type of attributes, like where people think you're handicapped and you're not. You know, all these different things are coming in the limelight for you to understand. Oh, wow. You know, it's just like with me and my dad. There's a lot of people I've came across and were like, oh, your energy is so familiar to me, or oh, your face looks so familiar to me. And I used to be nicknamed the face and did not understand. My dad was nicknamed the face too, because he always makes these crazy, you know, faces. On top of the fact is that energy is so profound that it makes people like, whoa, what is that? And it's very beautiful. And I didn't know a lot of these things, but it's just like when I finally was putting two and two together, and I was just like, wow, we had to be disrupted. You know, it's like, you know, darkness did not want two people. It's like he already, you know, he was already enough with him running around here. But being able to know you got the exact same kind of type person like this, but step the opposite sex, oh hell no, we ain't putting y'all two together. That's just too much. You know, so darkness made sure we were just, you know, steady, you know, apart. There are still people that try to keep me away from, you know, my dad's energy, which is sad. But, you know, hey, things happen the way they happen. If it's meant to happen, it will be regardless of what people want to do or try to intervene or whatever. But just allow when you think to things towards yourself, and you know it might something be something you blurt out, and you're like, why did I just say that? Or certain things will come into your, you know, your visual, like you might visualize something. You know, and it's just like with people, you know, I say, God, there are certain people that are coming back to the forefront or coming back from my past, and they're not meaning well for me. You know, there's just like a smoke screen will come up, like I'll see a smoke screen and I'll get a visual of somebody's face that's trying to pull a smoke screen on me. And I'm like, thank you so much. You know, it'll be a messed up situation because I could really, you know, have a good connection with this person. But if they're telling me, hey, you need to watch out for this person, I'm be like, okay. You know, and I'll just say what I need to say, but I don't hold no ill will towards nobody because they're just doing their part. You know what I'm saying? So it's just like, I can't get mad at that because that's the role they had to play in my certain situation. But it's like all the things, as soon as I said that, my daggone phone lit up and it's like 11:51. So it's just like going through all those situations, you know, and as soon as my head, you know, my head start itching, it's just like, if I get on the right track about certain things that they want me to talk about, all of a sudden I get this tingle at the top of my head and I just start scratching and then chills. You know, you can probably, you see my hair is just like standing up on end right now because there's a lot of things that's coming up for folks that, you know, you need to be aware of. When you never second guess your intuition, never second guess the visualizations that they're placing in your head. If they're trying to tell you to leave somebody alone, leave them the hell alone. You know, if they put them out your life, don't be trying to go back to them. Don't be trying to open a door that God has meant for you to stay shut. And sometimes you got to put a damn padlock on that situation, because some of y'all, as well as myself, is hard-headed as hell and be trying to open that lock. Like, no, I got something better for you. Now leave that alone. You come focus on this. And sometimes we're so focused on that damn padlock, you know, blessings be opening and shutting through that door. You're going to miss out on your blessings because you mess with a door that's meant to stay locked for you. So allow yourself to be able to see the visions that they're giving you. And if you're getting a vision about it and then you speak it out towards yourself, wait until you're by yourself and you'll definitely understand what I'm saying. You'll see something, you're like, did I just see this and this and that? And next, you know, you get that chill at the top of your head. It goes from the back of your back and comes out on your arms and where everything's just standing on in all your hair. You're like, woo, okay, that's your confirmation to tell you, hey, you're on the right path. You know, because there are some people that be trying to, you know, there will be so many things that's going off in your head, just like the video before last. If y'all seen that, when I got, you know, my words weren't coming out the way I wanted to. It was like so many different energies was coming at me, and it's just crazy how I feel them before I actually do my video. I feel y'all coming first, you know, and there are so many things that's kind of, I'm trying to project out saying something, and next thing you know, somebody's thought is coming down for me as well. So it's just like my gift is like on 20 right now, where I'm visualizing a lot of things that's going on in people's life. People are trying to understand why certain things are popping off the way they pop off, or why am I getting confirmation in the most weirdest ways. And I said that, and it's 11-11 on there. You had to be able to confirm those things. You had to go through so many different tragedies. You have to go through a lot of mishaps for you to be able to understand why you had to go through the understanding of understanding. That's what you got to understand. You know, so you gotta go through all these confusing situations that normal people ain't gonna understand. People that are still asleep are not gonna understand. So you have to be able to go through certain things like that, because that's their way of, you know, basically communicating with you is a certain confirmation. If they tell you, hey, did you want me to go back this way? Or if you're, you know, you're riding on the fence with a certain decision, if you say something like asking, please send me a sign, you know, and then you're like, next thing you know, you're going out with this, and then you experience that, you know, different things, and it'll give you that chill to understand. So I hope you were able to resonate with the content of my video. I'm gonna give much love to Diet Foods, much love to you. I love Diet. Diet comes out with these beautiful recipes and stuff like that. They are really short, but it's just like, I'm glad she's able to do that, because, you know, like with me and other people, sometimes we can't stay in attention with a certain video, and it's just, I don't know what it is. It's like I love to hear stuff, but then it's just like, you know, with all the downloads I'll be catching, something will have me this way, something will have me this way, or sometimes I can be attentive on the video. It just depends on what you're doing. But it's just like, with hers, is very short and sweet. You can go on her channel, it's DI Foodie Vlogs. I'm gonna go ahead and get on her link and put it on here. But she has a lot of delicious recipes. Like, I mean, I've just be saving all of them up in a playlist. Like, okay, if I want to go ahead and make this, I'm gonna go ahead and try this. So I'm just loving the fact is that Diet puts out different recipes, and some stuff I didn't even be aware of. You can put certain things in it, you know, to make the food pop like that. Oh, thanks, Diet. I didn't even know that. But, you know, anyways. Much love to you as well. I hope everybody was able to resonate with this video that had to come forth and feel this as well. And this is your confirmation. If there's things that you're riding on the fence with, you know, you get that chill. Like, wait a minute, was I supposed to watch this video? And then you'll get a chill or whatever. You'll understand that, yes, this was brought to the forefront for you. So never underestimate, you know, the visual, you know, things that they place in your, you know, your thoughts. Don't ever second guess your intuition. If there are certain things that they draw you back from, draw back. If they tell you to go forward with something, go ahead. And I mean, sometimes it might feel scary to you, but you need to be able to go through that unknown, because they want you to be able to promote something more about your life. They want you to put more, you know, entertainment or excitement towards your life. Because it's like, a lot of times when we do stuff that we're scared of, you know, end up being for our benefit as well. Anyway, so send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. Send out as much love and light and positivity. I said that twice. I don't know why, but just send it out towards people, because you never know, there are kind words can really take somebody a long way. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, and forever loved. And knowing there's always somebody out there praying for your better days. So drop me a line. Let me know if you resonate. You know, hit that notification bell. Subscribe, share, give me a thumbs up. And all is appreciated. And I will see you on my next video. Much love. Peace.